All right, here we are at the gym, 6:12 in the morning. I'm gonna start doing some more stuff inside the gym, like actually working out and actually showing you like my workouts, my posing. By no means am I a trained professional, aside from the fact that you could just look at my physique and determine for yourself if you think I know how to work out. I've been working out since 5 years old. My dad has always had me training with sports, in the gym, cardio. I've done just about every form of exercise you could probably think of. But I'm on my own now. I do my own workout routines. I manage everything from my food to my exercise. My food I don't technically manage. I really just like, I'll either fast or I'll just try to keep it clean. Nothing crazy. I don't calorie count, I don't do any of that stuff, but what I do is I go for a shredded physique, right? So I'm not trying to gain weight, I'm not trying to like cut or anything like that, but I am trying to maintain as well as increase the cuts that I already have. In terms of like gaining size, I like to gain weight relatively slowly. So if it takes me a month to gain 5 pounds of lean muscle, then it takes me a month to gain 5 pounds of lean muscle. I don't care, because I'm not going for like super like mass, just straight mass. I'm not going for that. So for anybody out there that's like trying to do the same, go ahead and, you know, follow, watch me, try out the things I do in this video. If you have no like workout experience, you know, feel free to do the exact same things that I'm doing. See if they work for you. And remember, like, results don't come on your first day of working out. They come after like months, you know. You're not gonna see major results for a while, but you will start seeing results if you hit it hard for, I guarantee, if you hit it hard for 2 weeks straight, if you're sore every single day for 2 weeks straight, you're gonna see results. Guarantee it. And if you're not starting off from like a smaller frame, so let's say you're not very vascular or you're not very thin to start off with, you'll see results in other ways. You're not going to see results in the fact that like you're just going to hit abs for 2 weeks straight and you'll start having abs, because depending on where you start, everybody starts somewhere different, but depending on where you start, you're just not going to, even if you're sore for 2 weeks straight, you're just not going to see the results, but you will see them in other ways. So you'll see it in, you could lift more weight, you'll see it in, you could do more reps, do more sets, you'll see it in the fact that maybe you just feel better mentally, emotionally, you'll feel better. But aside from that, I'm going to try to get in the gym. I don't have like a mic or anything like that, I'm literally recording on my old phone, and I have like my phone right here. But what I was thinking is like maybe I set up my phone and then I just kind of like use this to like, I don't know, record my voice. I don't know if I have like a audio recording app or something, but we're gonna try to do that. I'll try and walk you through some of the poses, we'll do the best we can. I have my tripod too. I don't know, I'll probably just buy like a cheap mic on Amazon or something, but let's get in there. And I think I'll make it into a separate video actually. Or maybe not, I don't know. Well, we'll do the best we can, yeah? And then we'll see what happens from there. But I have plenty of time to get into the gym. It's leg day today, unfortunately. I'm definitely not an expert at legs. But I know some brutal workouts. Will I be doing brutal workouts today? Probably not. But I do have work later. So we'll do the best we can. I'm just in the parking lot, and I saw like a bodybuilder that like I used to talk to a bit. He was like freaking built, like I did a leg day with him one time, and like, yeah, he's a bodybuilder for a reason. That guy's absolutely massive and his legs are like cracked, so I haven't seen him in a minute, but I guess he started coming early. Look at that, when you wake up early you start noticing all the other people that also made changes in their lives. But yeah, let's get in there, hit a nasty workout, and we'll do the best we can. All right, so I tried using my headphones to record the audio, but unfortunately For whatever reason, when I press record, they don't want to pick up audio from the headphones. It picks up audio from the phone. So I'm just going to kind of walk you through what I'm doing right now. So I kind of just hit up a warm-up with a couple of, like, movement stretches. So you kind of just want to, for me at least, I like to warm up my legs a lot. So air squats, squats with just the bar, anything that kind of stretches the joints, gets them warmed up. I feel like that's how I can hit the most amount of weight with the most amount of reps. If I'm cold, I don't know, I feel like I'm just not as strong. So I'll kind of just do some air squats, do a couple sets with just the bar, and then we'll just kind of go from there. All right, so I finished my warm up. I hit 25s, just like a 25 instead of the 45. I didn't feel like I was warmed up enough, so I just hit a couple of reps of that. This is my actual starting weight, just 45 pounds. I'm not quite sure how heavy I'm gonna go, but I'm gonna hit 12 reps of this, kind of see how I'm feeling, see if I need to hit another set of this in order to be properly warmed up. But yeah, I'm thinking I'll go do this, then I'll do 10s, and then I'll do 25s, and then 225 total, and then I'll probably be done. I don't know. Then I'll go do leg extension or something. But one thing I want to focus on when I do these is I go ass to grass. Not everybody can, but if you can, try it with good form, of course. Honestly, you're gonna build the most amount of strength if you focus on your form before focusing on going up in weight. So one thing I try to do is on my first couple of sets, really just focus on form. Don't even really worry about how heavy my first couple of sets are. Even if it's just the bar. That way it translates into, once you're doing your PR, you're gonna have like the best form possible, meaning you have the highest output of strength. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Just like focus on your form, and over time that form is going to translate into a lot more strength rather than doing sloppy form. And maybe you can hit more sooner, but it's a higher potential of getting injured, higher risk. So I'll just show you what proper form for me looks like. I'm pretty lengthy, my legs are kind of long, so I kind of look like a spider, but I mean that's just how it is if you're tall. Alright, so that was 12 reps. One thing that helps me focus on form is contracting the right muscles. So for back squats, which is what I just did, focuses a lot on the quads. So focus on flexing those quads to get you to stand up straight. When you do that, it's going to help you to also not only get down that muscle memory for proper form, but it's also going to train your body to have that mind muscle connection and let it know that when you're doing squats, you're working out your quads. Technically it works out the whole leg, but
primarily it's the squat, the quads. If you don't know, it's quads because there's four muscles. You have four individual muscles in your leg, in the front part of your thigh. You have more, obviously, in your thigh, but a lot of smaller muscles and stuff like that. But right now I'm focusing on just the quads, and we're gonna go up by 10 pounds. All right, so we're about to hit the 45 and 10. Just gonna go for 12 reps again. After that, do 25s. Leg day's kind of a short day, so I kind of dragged my feet getting into this, but it's cool because it's not that long of a day. I should have plenty of time to hit everything that I want, which is good. That's the main goal of coming into the gym at this time, is there's barely anybody here, and I want to be able to finish my entire workout. You know, when I was going after work, there was too many people. I had the time, but there was just too many people, and then, like, I didn't want to drive back home and then waste gas coming all the way back over here, so I figured before work is probably the best idea. If you're somebody who wants to work out, but you just can't seem to find the time, you kind of have to make time. You know, you got to, like, you have to change your schedule around. It's going to take, like, some sacrifice a little bit, but it's fine. You know, if you want that six-pack, you know, you're going to have to do what it takes to get it, you know? So, let's hit this set, and then we'll go from there. Okay, this is a little harder than I thought, but it's fine. I feel a little bit lightheaded. That's okay. Starting to see stars. Also, you saw that I was stretching my back out, hanging from the pull-up bar right there. But when you're doing squats, don't underestimate stretching out your back. It feels amazing. Think about it. You've got all this weight just resting on your shoulders, on your back, compressing it. I mean, your back doesn't exactly appreciate that, but you and your back need to work together. So stretch it out, especially before. Warm up your back on if you're gonna do squats and stuff like that. It's always good to have your entire body warmed up, even if you're not working out that specific part of the body. Again, prevents injury. And the last thing you want is an injury, because I could put you out of the gym for months. So stretch out your back, you know, get it warmed up. Maybe even get a good little sweat going, you know. But aside from that, let's get those 25s on, yeah? All right, so got the 25s on. Also, water. If you're somebody who doesn't drink water, lots of it. As you can see, I have a gallon of water. You don't have to do that much, but I don't know, I really like water. So I like to carry around a lot of it. But yeah, water is good for your joints, it's good for your bones, keeps your joints lubricated, you know, it's always good. And it helps cycle things out of your body, things that your body doesn't need or doesn't want. When I think about it, a lot of people drink water when they drink a lot of alcohol, because it cycles the alcohol out of the system. So, I mean, it works for literally anything. That's the whole point of defecating, right? Get rid of the things your body doesn't need. Kind of gross, but also good. Anyways, So I'm not really feeling like hitting this this set, I'm gonna be honest. Then again, what set do I actually really care about hitting? Probably none of them, but it's right there in front of me, so I kind of have to hit it. So a lot of times, you always hear like, it's that first step that's difficult. It's kind of true. But I always find like, once I get started, it's like super easy. Or not really easy, but it feels more comfortable. And that's what I do with sets like this. I'll just, you know, I'm just like, I'll actually go in saying like, I'll just do one rep. And then I end up doing like 12. Why? Because once I'm already underneath the bar, I'm like, man, it'd be a waste if all I did was one rep. So, screw it. Let's get hit one rep, and then we'll see from there. Okay. Right about now, maybe you've noticed that I don't have a belt on or anything, like a lifting belt. I don't have like knee straps or whatever the fuck. You might be wondering like, oh, you're probably gonna injure yourself, right? Like, no. I'm not a power lifter. I don't need that stuff. I'm sure it'll help, but I'm not like putting three plates on here trying to do back squats. Like the most I'll do, honestly, the most I've ever done was like, was it two plates and a 25? That I used the belt for. But that was for a PR months ago. I don't know, I find that I don't need straps or wrist straps or anything like that, or weightlifting belt. I mean, I have them, but I don't really use them because I don't know. Something about it doesn't feel like I really need it. It feels like it's kind of hindering me sometimes. So, I just kind of ditched them. So, we're gonna do two plates now. I'll be back once I have those on. All right. So two plates are on. Yeah, I'm not sure what I'm gonna go to next. Leg extensions, I think, typically what I go for after. Let's see, it's 7:02. I have to be out of here. I have to be getting ready for work by like 7:50. So I have about, about 50 minutes, let's say. 50 minutes, and then I have to get ready for that. I think we can finish the workout. Honestly, it's always like the first exercises that take the longest for me, like squats, deadlifts, mainly because I need that longer break in between. But other than that, once I go to like machines, workout starts going quicker. So yeah, we'll hit this, move on to leg extension, and I'll probably do like six sets there. Hello. Let's see. I think I'm gonna go for like two reps here. My goal isn't to hit 12 quite yet. I think I've hit six total before, like in one rep, one set. That was a different time. Right now I'm just trying to maintain. So hitting two reps is kind of what I need to do to maintain. because my cuts don't really come from hitting heavy, they come from hitting lots of reps. So this is just to keep some of the size, some of the mass on my legs. At least that's the thought that I have. I'm not sure if that's backed by scientific evidence, but I mean, it kind of makes sense. All right, let's get it. Alright, well, form probably wasn't the best, but we'll wrap it up there and move on to the next exercise. Alright, here leg extension. This isn't the one I wanted. There's two different ones, the other one's taken. So we'll do the best we can. It's about, yeah, it's a little bit past six, so more people are showing up. Kind of unfortunate, but I'd say the good news is I'm not feeling self-conscious about recording myself. I find that to be a pretty lame emotion to have, because it definitely prevented me before or in the past from doing videos and stuff like that. But I don't know. I've been feeling more confident about like recording in public and stuff like that, because I don't know. I've just been noticing that people, they just don't care. They're like, oh, this guy's got a camera, cool, like whatever. So. And we do the best we can. So let's, I'm gonna do like six sets here, but I'm gonna do them kind of quickly because I wanna get to hamstrings and calves, and I also wanna get to posing. So I'll probably try and spend like 10 minutes here, 10 minutes at lying leg curls, and then like 10 minutes of calves, maybe less, I don't know, we'll see. I'm okay with baby calves, it's okay. Okay, so first set completed. There's a couple reasons I don't like this calf machine or this quad machine. I'm not gonna say like I'm some absolutely tall ass giant, like, but this one, it feels like it's meant for people that are a little bit shorter, which is okay. But like the seat doesn't go as far back as I want it. Like it has a stopping point, a pretty like close stopping point. But other than that, like in terms of like with my leg space, it's fine. It just feels a little bit cramped. But as far as what I do, so I do six sets, but three sets of like my feet are just gonna be like this. Then I do another three sets where my feet are pointed in, and the reason for that is, all right. Well, pretend my hand is my foot, and then my forearm is my calf, my calf. So when you point them in, this goes for really doing quads, working calves, and even like hamstrings. Depending on where your foot is pointed, that's going to be where the tension is on your muscles. So when I point it in, the outer part is going to be worked more. So let's say there was like a wall that I'm pushing against. When I point in, it's going to be the outside of my forearm is going to be like pushing more. So when I'm doing leg extensions, the outer quad is going to be worked more when I have my legs pointed in. I think that's how it works. It might be vice versa, actually, now that I think about it. But I don't know. I've been doing it like this for a while. So, yeah, we'll see how that works. So, yeah, I do three sets pointed, like, straight, and then three sets pointed in. I'm supposed to be doing, like, three sets straight, three sets in, and then three sets out, but that to work like the full quad, but I don't really have time for that, so I'll meet back up with you once I am doing like faced in. Right, so I have one more set of straight facing toes, but I go up by 60 pounds when I do leg extension. Because when you're doing machines, you can go up a lot of weight. And since it's a machine, the joints of the machine are what's gonna take a lot of the load for you instead of like putting the force on your knees or any of the joints on you. So that's one of the good things about doing machines. So for somebody who's scared of like free weights or worried that they might get injured doing free weights because maybe they don't have the muscle mass or the proper form down yet, always good to start with machines. It's like the safest thing you can do. Even then, you still have to have proper form, but it's not as crucial because it's kind of hard to mess up on the form. But yeah, so I go up by 60 pounds every set, and then I do 30 reps, because I'm trying to have cuts. So all that repetition is going to like force my muscles to have to be shredded, very dense, and able to do like have a lot of muscle endurance rather than being bulky and being able to just lift a lot of weight, whether it's like once or twice. So yeah, I have one more set and then I'll do the last three sets with my toes pointed in. All right, so I'm on to lying leg curls to work on hamstrings. I do 3 to 4 sets here. I'm not going to show you the behind angle because I'm not trying to show off my booty like that. So you'll be getting probably the top of my head angle. But it's lying leg curls. If you haven't done, I don't know, a lot of people don't like doing these because you're lying down. But I'll be honest, I feel the most pressure on my hamstrings when I do these. So I figured that these are probably better than seated hamstring curls. I don't know, seated hamstring curls, I just can't feel the pump, so I just stick with these. These I do regular sets, so 12 to 15 reps, and then 3 to 4 sets, just kind of depends. I go up every set by like 10 pounds, so yeah, we'll see. Let's get it. So those felt pretty good. I'm actually about to hit a set pretty shortly after that because, I don't know, they felt pretty good. I feel like that's gonna be a pretty nice pump if I kinda don't have too long of a resting period in between. My quads are they're feeling pretty pumped up right now. I'm like kinda squatting right now to talk into the camera. But yeah, my quads feel pretty swollen right now. But I'm gonna hit that next set, and after that I have like one or two, but we'll see. Thank you. Yeah, I don't know. I'm liking how that feels. It feels good. The pump is for quads, feels good on these all the time. So yeah, I like hitting quads on the long leg curls. It's pretty fire. It's not too bad. Yeah, after this I got calves and then a little bit of posing, I guess. A little bit of leg posing, although I'm no expert at leg posing, let alone upper body posing, so I just kind of do what looks good on camera or from my perspective in the mirror. And I just kind of play around with it, feel it around, and yeah, posing's also good. It's good for muscle formation and definition. Literally, if you didn't work out, but all you did was like flex the muscles that you wanted to like increase the cuts to, if you did that for like 20 minutes a day, you'll probably see like improvement, because all working out is flexing those muscles with weight. So if you flex them and without any weight, you're still gonna get muscle fatigue and stuff like that. So it's kind of interesting. All right, let's hit this next set though. Okay, yeah, I'm feeling pretty good with just that. I don't think I'll hit another set. And it's getting pretty packed in here, so I kind of need to hurry up and move to calves. I'm gonna do calves real quick. I'm done, you guys are good. All right, so we're gonna hit some calves. We have 55 pound dumbbells right here. I don't do a lot for calves, I'll be honest. I don't do as much as I should, and I blame 9 to 5 for that, I'll be honest. Because I know damn well if I didn't have to spend so much time at work, or if I was part-time even, I'd have much more time to hit every muscle group every muscle I want, with the amount of sets, reps, and exercises that I want. But yeah, so for calves, similar to the leg extension, you can do them with your feet like this. So you'll push off like this, and then you can also do them with them in, so you push off like this, and then also out, push them off like this. So it just kind of depends on which part of the calf you want to work, whether it's inner, center, or outer, but all are good. I do like 50 reps with these, because think about it, you're on your feet all day, or you're always walking around, so all your leg muscles are very strong already, because you're walking on them 24/7, so if I want them to be cut, I have to do even more reps with them, whether it's calves, quads, or hamstrings, in order to get that muscle growth or that muscle cut. So aside from that, I'm gonna hit these and then I'll check back in. All right, so I just realized I didn't show my exercise at all, but I'll do it right now again. I just finished a set, so yeah. It's a little bit bent. There we go. All right. So, this is a super simple exercise for building calves. You can do this just like this with dumbbells, or you can do it on leg press. Why do I feel like I've said that before? anyways, yeah. So, remember, whenever you're hitting legs, you're gonna have to do a lot of weight and a lot of reps. Because you're on your legs all day, and especially if you're like somebody who runs a lot or walks a lot, or just does a lot of moving around using their legs, you're gonna want to do a lot of exercise in the gym, a lot of reps, a lot of sets, to build those muscles properly, in the way that you probably want, because your legs are probably really strong already. Like, I think a lot of people underestimate how strong the legs really are. And so when they get into the gym and they can't maybe hit the weight they want or the amount of reps that they want, they forget that your legs are literally being used like 24/7. So just remember that. And let me hit the set real quick. So I don't know if you saw, but I was like falling forward a lot. That's okay. If that happens to you, that's okay. It's fine. My legs are already pretty beat up from the leg workout. Not as bad as they could be. But I guess I didn't have as much time in the gym as I thought I was, but it's okay. We can always try again next time. Maybe try and get in here a little bit sooner. I did sit in the car a little bit, drinking my pre. So I don't know, maybe tomorrow, I'll bring the pre in with me and drink it while I'm like warming up and talk to you guys while I warm up. But I think I'm gonna do one more set of these calves, and then I'll go into the mirror room so that I can kind of show you some poses for legs, I guess. We'll hit it quick. Then I'll meet you guys back in the mirror room. All right, so we're here in the gym. No kidding. We're here in the mirror room so that I can show you some leg posing. And since I can't turn off all the lights in here or dim them, I'll just dim the camera a little bit. And I'll kind of try to walk you through my thought process on doing leg poses. So, I feel like that's too dim. I'll try to brighten it up a little bit. I just want a little bit dim to kind of emphasize the cuts a little bit more. No, maybe if I move underneath the light, that might be a little bit of a better idea. All right, let's see, how's that look? That doesn't look too bad, I guess, but let's try to. Alright, there we go. So, let's see, how much time do we have? Okay, yeah, we have about 20 minutes. I don't know that I'll use all of that to demonstrate posing, but alright, so as you can see, I'm gonna be honest, my legs don't look super cut right now, but they're pretty pumped up right now. They feel pretty, I can feel like the blood pumping around in there, and they definitely don't feel like they're small. Maybe they do look small, I don't know. Definitely need to hit more legs, but again, working out isn't my job, so it's kind of hard to work it out the way I want to, because I know my physique would be crazier if it was my job, because I would be in here like 4 hours out of the day. I guess it's just part of the 9-to-5 grind, huh? This is like my part-time job, essentially, is working out. But, because right after work, before work now, I do this job, and then I go to my actual job, my other job. So, leg posing. I'm no professional, but this is what I like to do. I play around with it, but it's always like this V-like shape that I try to make, with the, like an upside-down V, actually. So it kind of goes like this. And like imagine my hands on my legs like this, but I'm not the best teacher, I guess, but we'll try to make it work. So I also push my hips like back, so if you notice when I'm like to the side, if I do the same pose, like I don't know if you can tell, but like my body is slanted, my upper body is slanted forward a little bit and my hips are behind my knees, and I don't know why, whenever I do that I kind of feel like it emphasizes my legs more. So, and I do a pretty drastic, like, lean forward sometimes. Like, I'll literally lean like this. Like, that's a pretty, like, steep lean. So, So it doesn't really matter which foot you have forward. Let me see if I could kind of move this back a little bit. But you can see my feet. My right foot, the heel of my foot is kind of parallel with the tippy toes of my left foot. And I'm just kind of creating that V to kind of, when I'm taking this picture, right, I want my quads and my leg, the circumference, I want to really emphasize the circumference and really show off like the thickness of my leg. So when I go like this, it doesn't look that thick, but when I go like this, it looks thicker. Why? Because I have this outer quad that's pumped up, right? So it almost pumps up forward a little bit, which is why you want to tilt it to the side, so that when you flex it, it almost looks like it's pumped up sideways. So in practice, you go like, I could flex my legs like this, right? Like, looks, I mean, they don't look terrible. You know, my teardrop is right here. I'm not sure if you can see, like, again, the lighting in here. I can't dim it. So there's a teardrop, which is this part right here. And then there's, I'm not sure what all the names are, but then there's like this little arrow one. I call it the arrowhead because it when you can see it, right now I guess I didn't work it out that hard, but when you can see it, it almost looks like a little arrowhead. And then you have the outer quad. So you just focus on getting that proper stance and getting that teardrop to kind of be at the front, and then your outer quad to really be on the outside and really emphasize that thickness. Then also you go the calves, you have the calves. So I like to kind of almost even take my pictures on my tippy toes. So I'm on my tippy toes a little bit, right? So like this is my foot flat, this is like how I take them. So flat, and then there's like kind of the angle that my foot is at when I'm taking pictures. So bring that over here, flat, and then here's how it is when I take the picture. And then my back foot, here's my back foot flat. And then here's it tippy toeing a little bit. See, there's a little bit of a gap between the heel of my foot and the floor. So again, you got the V. Go on your tippy toes a little bit to kind of flex those calves. And then this foot, you're almost like pushing down. You're pushing down with your foot to get that calf muscle to contract. So once you got that down, also one thing a bodybuilder told me one time was, and you hear this a lot, is you start from the ground up. So you start with your foot placement. So yeah, I probably should have mentioned that at the beginning. Start with foot placement. So feet angled, then you could kind of go on your tippy toes a little bit, flex those calves, then you flex those quads, and then I kind of lean forward or kind of just play around with it. Move your quads around, kind of see what makes it look the best in the picture. And then yeah, and I don't know that was the best explanation, but I'm no trained professional. I don't, I've never gotten any certificate. I just, all this stuff I either learned from my dad teaching me or from the bodybuilders that I asked or just watching videos. And a lot of it also came from trial and error. So I just came in here, or like any mirror. I mean, hell, even when I'm like, before I take a shower, I look at the mirror and I flex and I try to like, see, I can move my legs. My feet don't move, but I can move my quads to kind of get different angles. So if you're trying to get better at posing, you can have great looking muscles, but super defined and all that, but it doesn't matter if you don't know how to pose, because if that's the goal, to have good poses, it doesn't matter if you don't know how to pose, because you're not going to be able to emphasize those muscles in the right way. But that's fine, you know, it's part of the learning process. The gym is a great place to learn about your body, you know. You have a, it's all about that mind-muscle connection, you know. You can train your body to flex in certain ways that it couldn't do before, and get it to show off muscles that maybe were defined, but now they look even more defined because you know how to flex them properly. So with that being said, after the workout, it's always good to get a little bit of stretching in. So I think tomorrow I have chest and tries. So tomorrow I'll do like some chest poses, some tricep poses, and we'll see. Once I have a pump, you know, I feel like there's no point in like doing it without the pump, because it's harder to see the muscles. Because I'm not like, yeah, I'm like shredded, but unless you're like not natty, like your muscles are gonna look a little bit less pumped when you're not, when you don't have that pump. They're not gonna look as cut, they're not gonna be as vascular, and that's okay. It's fine. You know, there's nothing wrong with not being natty, but there's also nothing wrong with being natty. You know, it's kind of whatever you prefer. I mean, definitely always take things after consulting a doctor, of course, but personally, I try to keep it natty, but that results in me not always looking super shredded or me not always looking vascular. But that's okay, I'm fine with that. Why? Because for me, that's my motivation to get back in the gym. At least that's part of it. But aside from that, I think that's the end of this video. I hope I could have this out by today. I'm just not sure how it's gonna work out, me like stitching all these things together. But we'll see. I don't have a lot of time to edit it, so I'll probably just put everything together and then upload it, but it's gonna be like a 30-minute video, so that's what it is. I mean, you pretty much went with me through my entire workout. That's cool, you know, it's not bad. Remember, do the best you can. We do the best we can. If you stayed till the end, I appreciate it. Thank you. I hope there was some helpful information in terms of your workout journey or even your just personal life journey. Aside from that, if you haven't already, go out there, do the things you love, enjoy life, and I'll catch you tomorrow when I make another workout video.